click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hey friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about what are nanomaterials, and in that we have also got to know about the nanoparticles. And based on that, we are going to talk about the applications of the nanoparticles. So what are these applications? Let us talk about that. So here are the following applications of the nanoparticles that we are going to talk about. So starting with the first one, that is, the gold nanoparticles are effectively used in the selective oxidizing agents. Yes, because the gold particles or the gold nanoparticles, obviously we know that the nanoparticles have the size of, that is, from 1 nanometer to 10 raised to, that is, 2 nanometer. So that's the reason that because of this small, that is, size of these particles, they are very much effectively used as an oxidizing agent. And yes, they are more selective towards its reactivity. So that is the reason that there are a few applications of that. And now let us move on to the next one, that is, the nanomaterials of or the nanoparticles of the metal oxides are used as cosmetic products and are dirt repelling agent and are used as dirt repelling agents. So most of the nanoparticles are also being used in the cosmetics nowadays. So this is the second application that we are going to talk about. And now let us move on to the next one, and those are, so the next point are basically, we are going to talk about here, that is, the nanotubes of the carbon are used as strengthening rods in the structural composite materials. So therefore, these nanotubes of the carbon, they are, because they have various properties that we have talked about in our previous lecture also, and those properties about that is basically they have a good strength. So this, therefore this, that is, nanotubes of carbon, they have very good strength, and that's the reason that while preparing any kind of material, suppose if we are using this nanotubes of carbon, so they could give a proper strength to that material. And talking about the next one, that is, by attaching an organic compound to the surface of the quantum dot, and we also understand that what is quantum dot, it is basically the a kind of a semiconductor, a nanomaterial of which is basically a semiconductor, and the chemical properties that can be modified by using or by attaching the organic compound with that of the quantum dot. So this has a very wide application nowadays, and that could be used in the future also. And that is basically that can use the property of the DNA, and we can use that thing with the help of a quantum dot, and we could modify the that is the chemical reactivity or the bond attachment of the DNA with that of the quantum dot, and we could modify most of the properties of it. So therefore, these are the various applications that we have talked about in this lecture. So that's it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and you have got to know a few points or few applications of the nanomaterial or the nanoparticle. So I hope you have liked this video, and you will share this video with the friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.